Good afternoon, everyone. Let's just wait for a couple of more minutes for other people to come, and I will start. Just 2 more minutes. Hi, Maggie.
Hi.
Hi. Yeah, just let's wait for a couple of more minutes to come. We have some participants, but we're going to wait a little bit more.
Mm-hmm.
More minutes we start. I'll just share the presentation full screen. Starting a couple of minutes. Hello everyone. Let's just check the connection. I think, guys, first of all, in order to start, please put in a chat plus that you can hear me, so that I can see that everyone can hear me and there is no issue with the reception connections. So it's going to be a practical conversation. Today, other guys can hear me. Yes.
I think two people just messaged.
Other people just probably.
To those who are in the webinar, can you just please message to say that you can hear us?
Some of them shy, so it's okay. We're assuming that they can hear, Ilya can hear us, and Talia as well. Talia, obviously, she can hear us. She's just next to me. And Professor Dato. Lovely. I think we can start. So let's just a little bit introduce who we are, what we'd like to talk today. we are an immigration law firm based in three main cities, in London, Moscow, and Hong Kong. And today we are presenting a webinar series, specifically. Today we'll talk about a UK innovator visa. During the conversation, I'll explain the nitty-gritty and details of the UK innovator visa and how it works. And then after this conversation, you will have a short Q&A session. If it's required to take longer, if you have specific questions, we're definitely able to help you, and Maggie will take you all through and take the contact details and reach out and schedule a consultation either today or next following days. So our agenda for the webinar, it will provide necessary knowledge and detailed knowledge and pass it to you from our hands to you as a prospective client, so existing clients or future client. Maybe you consider in any other programs and you're just comparing. This is the agenda of today's webinar. Then title of the webinar is UK Innovative Visa Endorsement and Visa Application Process. So we cover the two sides of the visa, and we'll cover the business and investor visa trends this year. In terms of what we'll discuss, first of all, I'll explain about the UK Innovative Visa, some a bit more statistics, what's happening with the visa, when it started, Then I'll talk about business plan preparation for the visa. Then I'll talk about stage one endorsement process and stage two legal case for preparation. And we will cover UK business trends and visa trends in the UK for this year, upcoming changes. And obviously, Margie will discuss in brief details about Man Solutions. She'll explain what we are doing in the UK and how we can support you. So let's present and start from myself. So I'm the managing director of the company Immigration Advisor. The company is regulated by OICIC, which helps us to submit on our behalf all legal cases for UK visas in the UK. Margie is private clients advisor. She's supporting clients with the explanation about the visas and business visas, so investor visas in UK and abroad. And on this occasion, both of us, we can help and give nitty-gritty details to you. Let's talk about UK innovative visas. UK innovative visa is actually a replacement of the tier one entrepreneur visa category. And UK innovative visa started in March 2019. But lots of clients asking us, okay, what is the success rate for the PR or settlement visa for innovative visa? How is going to work? But realistically, on innovative visa, you have to stay for 3 years and then apply for settlement. Now, only in this March, is going to be first PRs. So in March 2022, it's going to be first PRs, so first settlement card will be issued. So we don't know how the UK government or Home Office is working with the innovative visa, and we all will see, because this visa is pretty much new. I would say in general, it's a visa success. So nobody believed in this visa before. So lots of people expected that is going to ruin the immigration to the UK, business immigration to the UK is going to destruct it, because entrepreneur visa was quite straightforward, £200,000 and investment. Innovative visa is different. Let's talk about background for 2020-2021. By UKVI or Home Office statistics, in 2020, there were 222 visas granted, so innovative visas granted. And the refusal rates vary from 24 to 10%. How come the refusal rates vary? Because it's new visa, and obviously lots of endorsement bodies, the clients and other third parties were adapting to the requirements, and Home Office UK government was tough on this. They pushed away not qualified unclear and not professional endorsement bodies away from the market, and they withdrew the license. They refused the clients who had non-innovative idea or very poor business plan or very poor expertise. in terms of the Man Solutions success, we will talk at the end. So ratio success, but carry on. In 2021, the number of applications granted or the visa approved, and we're talking only about number of applications of main applicants. Obviously, all these people are coming with the families, so you can multiply by three, because average application has a three, average person or applicant has a three dependents for innovative visa. So in 2021, or by the end of 2021, it was 321 applications successful, and approximately with the refusal rate 11%, which is genuinely good, because as we say to our clients, we have a in average, 90% success rate. Home Office and UKVI, in overall, they're scrutinizing a lot endorsement bodies, and a couple of endorsement bodies went out of the market. They just in 2021, due to the non-ethical and non-professional behavior and experience of distributing endorsement letters. So this is pretty much about innovative visa, what's actually happening. And innovative, what's innovative visa about? Innovative visa, it's designed for experienced business people. So if person never run the business, I've never been under the senior management position, then highly unlikely will be refused by endorsing body and will be refused even though if they pass the first stage, they might be refused by the Home Office. We saw these examples because some clients approached us and we advised them on this matter so that they'll be refused. And they actually, some of them was refused from other companies based that they have been overqualified. Not underqualified, but overqualified is a bit different. Innovative visa, in overall, 3 points. It's £50,000 investment required. And this visa actually might have, or the business idea must have three main aspects: innovation, viability, and scalability. And endorsement body must be obtained. So without endorsement body, without clear business idea, and without £50,000, you cannot apply. Business idea must be new, innovative. It's critical. This visa valid for 3 years, so you can get ILA or settlement, PR, and you can bring the your wife, husband, and children under 18 years old. Even if the child be turned 18, just prior of application, as long as we submit the online application form and then the appointment, you're covered and your dependents are covered as well, so they can apply. We had so many cases when we just submitted 2, 3, 4 months before dependent turned 18. And it's easy to do even PR after 3 years. Why? Because as long as you prove that dependent, the person, the child still dependent on you, he can apply for PR, easy, and so on and so forth. Innovative visa endorsement criteria. Let's talk a little bit about this. Innovative visa business plan. You know, just have a specific business idea. And the business idea need to meet endorsement criteria. Innovation, it means new technology. Viability, it means a realistic business. It has to be viable. And scalability, it means business must grow to the stage of £100,000 turnover, £500,000 turnover, £1 million turnover, £10 million turnover, and so forth. If business is not scalable national-wise and internationally, then most likely the endorsing body might refuse, and even after UK VI, most might refuse as well. what does mean viable? And viable, as I explained, it's where business is realistic and it's matched with the CV, expertise, and knowledge of the applicant. That's why we always ask, please kindly provide your CV. When then we can assess your business idea, what you'd like to apply for, and so on and so forth. Yeah. And in terms of the innovation, must be genuine business idea, which is not presented in exact existing market, and which has a competitive advantage. You would ask, are you able to apply and set up the bank if the bank already exists? And lots of banks in UK already exist. Or you're able to set up marketplace, which marketplace exists, or HR platform, or CRM. Yes, you can, if you have a different proposition and different unique selling point of your business. So it must be not the same. So this is the important part. In terms of scalable, evidence of structured, clear structured job and planning for growth. As I explained, in terms of turnover, in terms of sales, in terms of number of people as well. The applicant must be not only make sure preparing the business plan, because the preparing business plan based on your business idea, our team of business department, we can support you. But the most important, we always say, please make sure you're going to execute a business idea. Just make sure once you come to the UK, you're going to execute it. We had the examples when the applicants prepare business idea, granted the visa, and they change direction. They can, as long as they confirm with endorsement body. because we have an applicant who applied from India, got innovator visa, and he successfully now changing the business ATM and endorsement body approved it. So he just granted the visa the last spring. Let's talk about business prep preparation and how long it takes. We define in three stages. So business plan preparation by our team, it takes in overall 2 weeks, and completion takes usually 3 weeks. So we define in the preliminary stage where we cover, set up the whole business plan writer, discuss the business idea, improve it if necessary from your feedback, and then get a CV from you. Then we draft in the business plan within 2 weeks. And then usually after draft, you have to review it, approve it, comment on this, and it takes about a week or so, maybe 3-5 days. So once you plan in your application, so on and so forth, then you can simply put in line how long it's going to take prepare a business plan, how long it's going to take to get endorsement and get the visa. Let's talk about endorsement process. So in order to recap endorsement process, we defined that it's split in 5 steps. First step is with each endorsement body, we are allocated to you, for instance, 3 or 4 or 5 endorsement bodies. We need to send a business plan and CV to endorsement body. Then after this, endorsement body instructing for the short interview, where you can present the in the review your business idea. Then once endorsement body is happy with business idea and they're able to take you, then we need to submit a key investor deck or document with just application form. We need to submit relevant documents about you, from your CV, from your education and experience background. And obviously we need to submit that you have a £50,000 available. Fourth step, it's receive approval from endorsement body. Approval, it means usually they send by email. Yes, they're saying we approved you, we are happy to take you on board, and they send a draft endorsement letter. Draft endorsement letter, it doesn't mean that you endorsed. It means you approved. And then in the fifth step, they're sending original endorsement letter with a serial number. As the home office issued to the endorsement body serial numbers, it's important to understand that it's a document which is allocated to you for only 3 months. So it's expired in 3 months' time. It's important to understand the endorsement body in overall and endorsement process. It might take time. And some clients asking us, can we apply ourselves to endorsement bodies? Yes, you can. It's nothing stops you to do so. But endorsement bodies usually working with firms of other introducers, because they usually overloaded within inquiries, and they're making sure that some companies are actually supporting them with a referral like us, and getting at least some pre-qualified and ready clients who has a business plan, who has a CV to review. It doesn't mean that the endorsement body will take on board the applicant, but it's much more quicker for the applicant to work with. That's why majority of applicants are coming to us first, and then we introduce them to endorsement body, and then we go through the whole process. And overall, let's explain a little bit what about endorsement body, who they are, why they involved in the process, and why need to work with them. Endorsement body, it's official, usually it's official private organization with a license from the UK government, from the Home Office. It can be an incubator, could be accelerator. Occasionally it's government agencies, but usually it's business development organizations who has a license from the UKVI. This an organization, endorsement body, they must have a track record, and they have advisors and people on the board, the endorsement body, on the board of directors, or board of advisors, who can help you as an applicant to grow your business after you get the visa. An endorsement body obviously prohibited to provide and prohibited to work with the law firms on the commission basis or so. So that's why we always say to our clients, we are not paid by endorsement body in any way. We just referring you to endorsement body and making sure that you are successfully go through the communication and making sure if your business idea is viable, innovative, scalable, you get endorsed. Also, endorsement body has a responsibility once you get the visa to manage you for next 3 years, for over 36 months, until you apply for the the Home Office might satisfy each endorsement body, monitor them, and issue particular number of serial number, particular number of cases on particular number of serial numbers to the endorsement body, and these serial numbers they can allocate to the endorsement letters. let's explain because many clients asking us which type of services endorsement body covers and why do they need to work with endorsement bodies. Endorsement body covers in a different endorsement bodies covers from 2 to 5 different services such as corporate support, admin support and accounting, mentoring and advising on the business. Obviously, endorsement support as a must, communication preparation of the reports because you need to prepare the reports and submit to the endorsement body on a quarterly basis, sometimes on a half year basis. And occasionally they provide growth and management support, which is crucial as well once you set up the tech to manage it. Let's discuss how to choose endorsement body, how to choose the right one. First of all, you need to ask, once you introduce the endorsement body, does the endorsement body has the relevant industry experience? Do the relevant expert on the board of directors, board of advisors of endorsement body within your industry, for instance? And do they have any links to entrepreneurs or investors or, in particular particular industry where you operate? Why? So you can share experience. You might grow, you might raise the capital. And fourth, does endorsement body has a network with other third-party providers, with other key players on the industry, such as venture capital firms for the raising the funds, accelerators for further growth, and private equity firms for raising the investment. What are the fees and why are they charging the different fees? This is the common question we have from the class. Each body has a different fee structure. However, in overall fee structure is outlined and recognized by Home Office. So endorsement body cannot renegotiate fees because it's compliant with the UKVI. In renegotiate, I mean about the structure fees, about the amount, how much they charge. Potentially applicants can negotiate, but it's in the hands of applicants, us. There's a two type of fees they usually charge. It's a pre endorsement or pre-approval of the visa membership fee they charge upfront, and then it could be from £500 to £5,000. We have a different endorsement bodies they charge differently, and after you obtain the visa, they charge in monthly fees, which is usually from 450 to £1,000 plus VAT per month. And they obviously charge your company. Once you operate the company and you open the bank account, then they start charging you. So this is about endorsement bodies. Let's talk about a legal casework preparation. Yes, stage number one, endorsement is a critical because without stage number one, you cannot move forward. You cannot even submit a case to KVI. In regards of the stage number two, a legal case or preparation, we will cover 5 points. First of all, it's source of funds to be invested, so where money come from. Second of all, it's suitable experience and qualifications. Then endorsement business plan, and then legal representation letter. What's the legal representation letter? And line form submission and appointment. In regards of the source of funds to be invested, there is a three option for the funds to arrive from. So first option, funds are arriving from a venture capital firm or even endorsement. And the amount of funds, obviously £50,000. And they issue the letter that they can support you and they give you this money in exchange of either shares or second option, overseas or UK company related to you on the business purposes, give you money, £50,000. We have our own examples where from overseas, we have our applicants who is has funds available from the business partners, other company, and with the funds available, the investors, another company. And the last point of funds, source of funds, is obviously your personal savings or your family savings. In regards of your family savings and it's or your personal savings, it's critical to understand that the type of services you provide and the business idea you do, it's irrelevant. But from the point of the where money come from, you need to show that money covered by tax return, show the evidence, or you sell the property, and then you show evidence again. So it's title deed, it's agreements, it's a bank statements, money arrived. Or if your family members provide you money, again, it's two documents required, evidence that it's a gift, document signed by the who provide the gift, family member, and evidence from the legal representative, from the lawyer who gave it to the money. So in terms of the actual source of funds, it's usually the most critical part, because money has to sit usually for 3 months in your bank account, unless also they identified where the money come from. Another side, which is critical and which is usually people refuse on the visa, it's suitable experience and qualifications. Suitable experience means for innovative visa that you had experience in this industry or you had experience in the same position. For instance, if you would like to do business in the medical industry, and however you are strong by the CV, you are strong in marketing, and you have a very heavy experience in marketing, and you have a co-founder who has experience in the medical industry, then it's quite simple that you can do join innovator team, and then where we will present you as a marketing director, and another person is going to be a co-founder, and another person is going to be co-founder with the medical experience. So you still can do the business, but we need to handle where you're going to add the value. Also, you can do your business on your own, even medical industry, but we need to assess how and where you're going to bring the people with experience in the industry. Qualification is important. We usually assess people who has a university degree. If your person doesn't have a university degree, it's difficult for them to convince endorsement body and then difficult to get UK visa. I'm not saying it's impossible, but I'm saying it's difficult. And another point is endorsement letter and business plan. Obviously, it's stage one. Without stage one, without getting the endorsement letter and have a business plan, there's no point to even submit. Why? They, in the online visa application form, we put details of the endorsement body. So we cannot put details of the endorsement body in online visa application form if person is not endorsed yet. And obviously there's a reference number as well needed. And let's explain a little bit about legal representation letter on my visa form. So what's about? Legal representation letter, it's this document provided prepared by our casework team. And this document is quite clearly structured by case law, by immigration rules, why you must obtain the visa and which documents, list of documents which we submitted online. So many clients asking why they need a presentation letter. The reason is because a home office caseworker or the person who decides on your case, once they receive it online, all documents, and they receive a legal representation letter where we representing you as a law firm, first of what they're going to do, they're going to read a legal representation letter. And if this letter is structured correctly and clear and tidy in a way who you are, how you show your funds, what's your business experience and business idea, and what's the list of documents you are attached, then immigration caseworker, home office caseworker can spend less time on your case and most likely you'll get a positive decision. Because we need to understand as well that caseworkers, they're human beings, and sometimes they take more time to review the case, and it's sometimes they take less time, and occasionally it can be subjective. We trying to make it happen, easier life for our clients to get the visa, and obviously for the home office caseworker to review the case. Once all documents above prepared, we have a digital copy of it and our casework team in the emails, and we prepare online application form, and then depends where you're based, could be Nigeria, India, in Turkey or somewhere else, then we are setting up account with a visa provider such as BLS or TLS contact. So it's a third company supplier where we are uploading all your documents online. We're showing to you confirmation that the documents uploaded, right? And then we're booking the appointment. And then you'll ask, okay, when I'm gonna pay the old fee, office fees, and then immigration health surcharge fees, other fees. So in terms of the cost and fees, in regards of the home office fees, you always pay them at the end of the submission online application form. So there is no need to prepare the funds for the home office admin fees and immigration health surcharge at the beginning. You should prepare them at the end of the casework. Once we submit online application form, first, what the home office will ask us online, please pay online via debit or credit card fees for the insurance. And then please pay online home office admin fees. Afterwards, we book in the appointment, uploading documents and booking the appointment, which is critical. Appointments can be rescheduled as well. And however, in 24 hours notice. So if you have appointment tomorrow at 10 o'clock in the morning, and now it's already 11 o'clock in the morning, so you cannot reschedule appointment. This is the critical to understand. How it can be done if you're not able to attend, whether it's going to be a problem with your application, no, it won't be an issue, so we can advise you on this, it's not a problem. But it's critical to understand that it can be to no effect on your application. In terms of duration, legal Case one preparation usually takes maximum from 2 to 4 weeks. The most lengthy period of preparation is a station of one, which takes from 2 to 3 months. So in overall, in order to be ready to apply for the visa, you need to bear in mind that 3 months is required. Well, once we applied for the visa, then you attend the appointment, and after you attend the appointment, it's critical to understand that it's 28 days required to make a decision. For the 28 days to make a decision, you can shorten as well if you apply for accelerated option. In some countries, accelerated option is not available. In some countries, it's available. It's 5 working days. Obviously, you need to pay additional fees. If you're traveling a lot, then you can simply, on a point of the appointment, you can request agent to give you passport back. They usually charge some small fees, and at the time of the appointment, they can scan your passport, give you back if you would like to fly tomorrow on a Schengen visa somewhere else. Once they made a decision, they send us email, then we inform you that you need to bring the passport back to the agent in your country. Then they'll put the sticker. And on this occasion, it's going to be straightforward for you as well. What you're going to do with the sticker and how long it's going to take? Sticker in the passport shows that you've been granted innovative visa, and it allows you to enter UK within the next three months. Also, it's important to understand that once you come to the UK, you need to collect actual visa, or BRP card or plastic card, and which is allowed you to stay here 3 years and simply work here and live in and so on and so forth, and be prepared for the applying for the settlement in 3 years' time. Most common question the clients asking us, can dependents apply after 3 years? The answer is, unfortunately, no. The rules are stating in very, I would say, practical way, because dependents can apply for the settlement or for PR card only after 5 years. So the only main applicant can apply after 3 years, so on and so forth. Yeah. So in terms of the trend, and in terms of the UK business investment visas in 2022, let's discuss briefly, because there is other visas available. You might heard sole representative visa, which is visa for the actually for the people who would like to open a branch in the UK. And another visa, it's startup visa for non-experienced people. It's going to lead to innovative visa. And another visa is the one investor visa, which is £2 million visa. So representative visa, the trend is simple. It's quite easy visa to apply. Why? Because of the, if you're working as a senior employee in a company overseas, if company has a £200,000 or more sales, and it's well established, you can apply. However, this visa most likely going to be either revised, or it's going to be brought new visa, mobility visa in April 22, which is obviously in 2-3 months time. it's been announced last year that the new visa coming in April 22, similar to our representative, which we have our personal opinion that it might change. So startup innovator visa, in terms of the updates, in 2021, there has been updates because of the some, at the beginning of 2021, there was high refusal rate. And the main reason is not innovative business idea. So we are working with the well-established endorsement bodies, and we are assessing our clients' business ideas and we take care of this, so to make sure that the client is has a high chance. So, because we heard so many stories from our potential clients when they're approaching firms in Dubai, somewhere overseas, and they providing them genuine advice and they stay best in franchising of the restaurant, so on and so forth. It's obviously not a good strategy and has a very strong refusal rate based on this, because idea must be innovative at the beginning. Could be disruptive within the same industry, which is old industry. Doesn't need to be new industry. So now and a couple of endorsement was out of the market in 2021, endorsement bodies, sorry. And this shows that UK government and Home Office scrutinizing and making sure that quality key players on the market available. So by doing this, Innovative Visa now stabilized the refusal ratio, and it has a less refusals than before. In terms of investor visa, it's £2 million investor visa. It's a more advanced level from the point of the money, but they're implementing new due diligence and new money laundering rules as well. So which is not allowing people from countries with a questionable money savings and money security on gifts coming to the UK. Because UK become more and more attractive year by year. And main strong point of the UK, UK understood the responsibilities to be competitive in the world in terms of their fighting for the new minds from the point of tech and fighting for the new capital, inbound capital to the UK. So that's why they're implementing new rules and new visas. And they're doing this successfully. First one is they an exit from the EU, or it's called Brexit. And then they implement new immigration rules and they scrap 4,000 pages of immigration rules. Once the Priti Patel, head of Home Office, came to power after she received the heritage of the very weak, lengthy immigration rules who allocated Theresa May those time for her job for the last 10 years. And she stated, Priti stated that she would like to revise it, and they did so, such as business immigration, and also they revised working visas a lot. It turns to 300 pages, very nitty gritty and clean immigration rules, which allows new entrepreneur, new workers with a good approach come to the UK. So now I'll just pass to the brief explanation about months. Magi, she'll cover a little bit and she'll explain how months work and how we deal briefly with the clients. Magi?
Okay. Yeah, sure. As I've been explained who we are and what we do. So Man Solutions, so we're an immigration law firm. We have 10 years of experiences. So we provide legal matters and legal affairs for private clients. We deal with investment, immigration by investment, and we mainly deal with types of visa, like for example, business visa and personal immigration visa, and we also deal with programs as well, like different countries as well, and we do lots of immigration law from our company. The services provide, also we are regulated OSC license. And we are regulated, so you can see in our government website that we're obviously licensed, and so you can check in our system. Evgeny, I don't know.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, basically, in regards of the communication with our advisors, with our team, we structured quite a simple way. So you can access to us in the office because we work from offices, physical offices, physical locations. You can access us in London, Moscow, Hong Kong. You can set up call, phone call, WhatsApp call as well. In terms of the onboarding clients, how we usually work is quite simple. First, we get in the introduction of the client, obtain the CV, and then we schedule a call and assess the business idea, assess the expertise, and give a qualified opinion. So what to do next and how to do it, right? In regards of the our clients, they understood the responsibility we take, so they're happy with the process and explanation. So in terms of the next, so we, if you have any questions, because I can see some people are leaving because they need to go. If you have any questions, let us know. Maybe you can answer now.
If people don't have any questions now and they'd like to have a separate consultation, then let me know. Then we can schedule a call separately with our immigration advisor, if that's the case.
Yeah, I think Mokshan has a question.
Yes. Hello.
Hello.
Okay. I have a question that I have already a company registered in UK, and it's a scuba diving magazine, but it's the first and only in Arabic language. Okay, do you think that making the company is registered in UK may give me an advantage for this endorsement body?
It's not give advantage, but it's you're able to do so for sure. So to actually apply the innovative visa when the company already registered. The most important company must be not non-trading. Okay, so this is the important criteria.
Okay, so okay, I will be in Russia in.
Sorry.
I will be in Moscow for the next 2 weeks. At the middle of February, I will be in Moscow. Can I visit your office there?
Yeah, of course. I am in East. The office and. It's 100% sure you can visit the office, and our colleague Natalia, she's on this webinar as well. She's present on this webinar, and so
okay, good.
100% you can visit. Yeah. So can you please?
Okay, because I'll.
We just need to.
Yeah, I'm hearing.
After this, if you don't have any call questions, you can just hit the in the chat your number, or then Natalia can drop you an email and ask. You can provide the WhatsApp number so you can communicate and schedule a meeting. It's not a problem.
Okay.
Yeah, in terms of your company, is it trading already or no? It's not trading yet.
My company is working from 3 years now.
In the UK.
But it's it's not in the. It's just registered the last year, but I was working without registration as a business idea here in the Middle East, in Egypt. So when I want to register it, I registered in UK because I am participating in many expos now as a media partner by this magazine. And it's a new idea because it's in Arabic, not in English or any other language, because the only Arabic magazine and the first. And also we have some, marine ecology, and everything, not just scuba diving.
Sure. So if your company is only registered but not trading in UK, it's perfect. We can use it. We can discuss in details in the office once you come 1-2 weeks in Moscow or London, whenever you come. So we can meet you and greet you and explain and assess exactly so in terms of this. Okay?
Okay,
lovely. Okay, I'll pass the message to, I receive your, thank you very much, I receive your phone number.
Yes, it's WhatsApp and Telegram also. They have Telegram and WhatsApp.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
That's okay.
Okay.
So, great. Maybe anyone else has a question? Okay. I think we have a...
one question, yeah. Camille.
Camille, basically, how long does the process in UK innovate a visa? In usually, it takes 3 months to obtain and obtain the endorsement body and prepare the case, and 1 month decision making. So in 4 months time, you should assume if it's all go perfect and you communicate with our legal casework team and you're helping them and we managing you. So it's 3-4 months. So technically 4 months. If depending, you delay the process,
sorry
Magia. Yeah.
So it's depending on the client situation, you know, when they provide when they provide documents correctly, then you have sufficient documents that, you know, will help to process your visa application quickly and promptly as well. So depending on the client situation.
Camille, maybe do you have any other questions? Mm-hmm. Okay. So Camille, you know, in regards to that, sometimes clients apply with their children and dependents, and they're considering school and so on and so forth. Actually, you can plan simply the process where either you can apply only for the visa first, or we can delay this process. How? So once we apply for the visa, we can put the date of visiting the UK 3 months ahead from the point of the application. Let's assume we submit an online application today. So we can put it simply from 1st of February, February, March, April. So we can put it 1st of May that you enter in the UK. So you need to enter the UK as soon as you get the visa. No, in your visa sticker is going to be stated. Yeah. In terms of the once you get the visa, you still have another 3 months to enter, because in your sticker is given 3 months to enter physically the UK. So in total, you have up to 6 months legal point. So it's a crucial to plan once you have a kids and family. Maybe anyone else has a questions as well.
I think everyone's happy with the information.
Yeah, great. So after this webinar, we will send out presentation to every attendee, and we'll ask, I think someone has a question. Yeah. Yeah, please. Adebo, please ask. Hello.
Thank you. Adibari, do you have any questions?
Unfortunately, the boy is compulsory to pay the to endorse the body.
It's a requirement from the Home Office, yeah.
Yeah. Part of regulation, part of the involvement of mentoring you, managing you as an applicant.
Does anyone have any other questions? I think Evgeny, I think majority might have questions after this webinar, so they probably want to schedule a consultation. So if anyone have any further questions, just speak to us and then we can schedule a separate call for that.
Yes, perfect. Thank you very much for all attendees. Thank you to Maggie to hold this webinar as well. So we'll send out during today the information with the presentation, and you ask the clients to communicate and to provide the phone number so we can approach you and support. Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.